Okay, here's a messy one. Put it on pause and see if you can figure this one out. There's a lot of ways to go about doing this problem. All right, what I'm going to do, I see all these negative signs. I'm going to go ahead and just use my power of a product and quotient rule to begin with and see what happens.
Okay, so if we just take each of the different factors in here, we've got x to the negative 2 raised to the negative 3. We have an n to the negative 3 raised to the negative 3. And that's the numerator. The denominator, we have x to the negative 4 raised to the negative 3, and also an n to the negative 2 raised to the negative 3. All right, let's now use the power rule. So in the numerator, I multiply these exponents, negative 2 times negative 3 right here. So that gives me x to the sixth, n to the ninth, over x to the 12th, over n to the 6th. Right, almost done. Now we've got more factors of x in the denominator, so I'm going to keep the x in the denominator and do 12 minus 6. We have more n's in the numerator, so I'm going to keep the n in the numerator, do 9 minus 6. There you go. That's one way of doing it. Notice you could have done this by taking everything inside the parentheses first and switched places for all the negative exponents, making them positive by putting them in the numerator if they were in the denominator and vice versa. And then you could use that rule, take the reciprocal and put it to the positive 3. So then you're back up to x squared n cubed over, oops, sorry, x to the 4th n squared to the positive 3, and notice you're going to get exactly the same answer. You could also simplify within the parentheses first. Okay, so let's say you were going to simplify inside the parentheses first. I have x to the 4th over x squared is going to be an x squared in the numerator. There's more n's in the denominator, so that's n. And then you could take the reciprocal the positive 3, and then you could use your power rule, power of a product rule, and you're still going to get n cubed over x to the 6th. In fact, I can see that 10 different students could easily do 10 different things, but in the end, that's the correct answer. I did it two different ways. Okay, have a good time. Keep working on them. A lot of different possibilities. Just make sure that you're always carefully using one of the true laws of exponents or the mean. Here's a problem. Now, there are different ways to do this. What I would suggest is, since you have something raised to a power that's positive especially, it might be easier to go ahead and just use the power of a product rule to begin with. So we have a to the 6th raised to the 4th power, b to the negative 2 raised to the 4th power over 4 to the 3rd power, a to the negative 3 to the 3rd power, and b to the negative 3 to the 3rd power. Okay, so now let's multiply the exponents on each of these. I have a to the 24th, b to the negative 8, 4 cubed is 64, because that's 4 times 4 times 4, a to the negative 9, and b to the negative 9. Now, at this point, you've got some options here. What you could do is take all your negative exponents and trade them across the fraction bar to make them positive exponents. So let's do that. I take all three of these, remove them, my a to the 24th and my 64th state where they are, but the b to the negative 8 is then a b to the positive 8 in the denominator, and I have an a to the 9th, and I have a b to the 9th. All right, now we're almost done. Got a to the 9th, that's positive, but I have a b to the 9th over b to the 8th. Last thing to do is to subtract those exponents. So we have a, oops, I forgot. We have a to the 24th times a to the 9th. So we want to add those exponents to get 33. And I'm going to subtract the b to the ninth over b to the eighth. You subtract the exponents, which is b, and it's all over 64. So that's one way to solve, not to solve, but to simplify this original problem here. Okay. Here's the same problem, but you could have solved it differently by dealing with all the negative exponents inside first. The only thing is you're going to get kind of a big fraction here. So I could write that as a to the sixth over b squared to the fourth power. And then I could write 4 over a cubed and b cubed to the third power. Now remember, the 4 is to the first power, so that does not get in the denominator. So you do have a complex fraction when you write it this way. So that's a disadvantage of starting out the problem this way. But now we could raise each to, you could use the product of a quotient rule. So I have a to the sixth to the fourth power over b squared to the fourth power divided by 4 cubed over a cubed to the third power and b cubed to the third power. So you can see it sort of does get messy here. So we have a to the 24th over b to the 8th over 64 over a to the 9th, b to the 9th, and now you'd have to multiply by the reciprocal. Right? Because you're doing, you have a complex fraction here, so you could times that by a to the 9th, b to the 9th, over 64. And in the end, we are going to get the same thing because we see the a to the 24th times a to the 9th will give me that a to the 33rd in the numerator. And also I have a b to the 9th over b to the 8th, so I'm subtracting those exponents and a 64 at the bottom. So there are, you know, there's more than one way to do this. So we have a to the 33rd, b over 64. Remember, that's how we did it. That's the answer without doing it a completely different way. So as long as you're using the laws of exponents, you don't have to go sometimes in a particular order. As long as you are using just one law at a time, that's the best advice I could give you.